said, everybody, the title's right. I did go to the dark side. I did buy a Harley. This is a 2021 Street Glide. Insert B-roll footage now. Man, you can't beat the sound of a Harley. You really can't. So, 2021 Street Glide. Why did I get a Harley? The short answer is, I just really wanted something I could ride more often. It's really tough having a stunt bike and wanting to like daily it or ride it around your neighborhood or anything like that for two reasons. One is, it's really difficult to not want to do bad shit on it, okay? So there's that. Two, it's just loud and obnoxious. It's not really super comfortable to take our actual ride on. So for that reason, you know, I needed something that was a little bit more comfortable, something that I could make videos on way more regularly, and, you know, something that I can ride around and not draw so much attention and that sort of stuff. Because when you live in an area to where, like, for instance, stunt riding, you know, this isn't Chicago, this isn't areas of the West Coast, it's not parts of Florida to where it's, like, super acceptable. Stunt bikes here draw a lot of attention because it doesn't look like it's supposed to. It's really loud, you know, and if you get caught doing a wheelie here, it's not like other places to where, like, you just pass by and the cops like, all right, well, that was pretty cool. Like, here, that's a big deal. Like, they'll bring out, you know, the whole squad to come chase a dude that just did a wheelie, which seems dumb, but that's the world we live in. So, anyway, I wanted something that I could make videos on a little bit more regularly and, like, give you guys a little bit something more, you know, vlog-wise, because, you know, two reasons. I mean, for one, like, I don't really talk a lot in my stunt vlogs. It's a little difficult for me to, like, really concentrate and talk, so, and stunt ride and all that stuff, so... it's a little easier to do this because I can stay on topic, you know, and just cruise and ride and whatever. So there's that. Details about the bike. I did buy it brand new. You guys are going to be mad at me because it already has 1,055 miles on it. And this is the first video I'm pumping out for a couple of reasons. One, I've been having like GoPro like audio issues. And speaking of, I really hope all this is working right now. I moved my mic to a different spot. I did some new stuff with some Velcro on the outside to kind of secure the adapter a little bit better. And then my GoPro mount on the front where the camera is just a struggle right now. I'm not going to lie to you. I really need to replace it because it's got a piece that's cracked. So probably before next year or after the beginning of the year, I'm probably just going to replace my entire helmet and do a whole brand new fresh setup. I'd like to get the GoPro 10, get the new adapter, all that stuff, and, you know, rig it out the right way. I do have a new microphone location, which is hopefully cutting down on wind noise just a little bit. And it's making it a little easier to hear me clearly without the sound of me breathing in your face. So, anyway, it's a 2021 Street Glide. This is the standard. It's not the Street Glide Special. So it has the 107 cubic inch engine instead of the 114. But I do have the upgraded infotainment system because I was like, okay, it's 2021. Like, you have to have a screen. That'd be kind of silly to not have, like, a touchscreen on a bike like this in this day and age. Because the standard comes with just like this little 4-inch like LCD screen that's not touchscreen, has buttons on the side, and I was like, that's not cool. And all I've done to this bike so far is change the slip-ons because the stock exhaust on this sounds pretty awful. I'm not gonna lie to you, there's really no sound to it at all. So I went with Tab Performance slip-ons with zombie baffles on the inside. It gives a really good throaty sound. It's just loud enough when you ride that, like, you can hear the bike, and if you really gas on it, it makes some noise, but it's not like overbearing to where it's like uncomfortable to ride for a long distance or something like that. So I'm really enjoying it so far. I have no complaints to this bike at all. There's a reason that, you know, the Harley name and, you know, Street Glides are so comfortable. Like, that's a reputation thing, and they really are. Like, it's quick to figure out why this is Harley's best-selling bike since 2006 when they came out with it. The Batwing fairing, love it. The sound system's great. for as big of an engine as it is, it's surprisingly fuel efficient. I really feel like I don't put that much gas in it to go a pretty far distance. And it's just comfortable to ride, dude. Like, cruise control is money because you can take your throttle hand off, which is nice. Both hands if you're brave enough and need to do something. Super nice to be able to move around. The saddlebags, another really cool thing. Having crazy amounts of storage on a bike is something that I've never been used to. You know, I can put an entire backpack in one of my saddlebags, you know, opposed to having to wear it, which is really interesting and kind of cool. So, I absolutely love it. Really no gripes about it. Nothing about it that I don't like. I did buy it brand new, so obviously I've already, have a couple of cosmetic things that have happened already, because the bike weighs 900 pounds. So I dropped it on the crash bar one time already, just leaned it over. And then I pulled out of a parking lot and scraped one of my exhausts out of like a gas station. So I was pretty pissed about that. So anyway, the next question that I know everybody will have, stunt bike. Stunt bike's not going nowhere. Like, don't worry about it. So I need to get some parts, because if you watch my last video, you'll know that I dropped it on the handlebars pretty hard and that was a rip. So they're bent. So I think I'm going to go to clip-ons instead of dirt bars just for the next go-around, just to try something different and see if I like it. I need a new radiator and some other stuff. So while it's really cold, like, we've probably got like 1, 2, 3 more weekends of like decent weather like today, where it's in the, you know, 60s and 70s that I can ride. But when it gets cold, I'm going to take apart the stunt bike completely and just really give it a facelift that it desperately needs. Because, I mean, it's looking kind of clapped out. I did sort out the engine problem, so it runs like a bat out of hell now. It's really fantastic. But, you know, the cosmetic issue and the, you know, bent parts and stuff that's not 100% could cause more damage later. And I don't want that. You know, I want to be able to keep it pristine and, like, keep it kind of nice. So, anyway, as far as what I've been doing, man, I'm not gonna lie, man, life's just been really busy. And I know I've said that in a lot of my videos, but that's kind of how it goes, especially whenever you have a channel that's dedicated to stunt riding and you can't stunt ride where you live. So, like, I have to travel to Houston to ride. That's my closest ride spot, and it's a good couple hours. And man, to be honest with you guys, I really can't do that every weekend. You know, because if I go on like a Sunday, that consumes an entire day for me, you know. So I'm gone from 10, 11 in the morning, and I don't get back, you know, and this is with getting some decent ride time in. I don't get back until like, you know, 6, 7 in the afternoon, so I pretty much burn a whole day to go ride, which I'm not saying isn't worth it, but like, it's life, you know what I mean? Like, you have a lot of other stuff that goes on as an adult, you know. There's a lot of things that you have to take care of and stuff that you have to do to, you know, maintain your everyday life. So it's kind of difficult to make time to do that sometimes, you know. And like, as a content creator, you know, it's equally as difficult, because like, I want to make stuff that you guys want to see. I don't want to put out crap, and I have, whoa, geez, that was a seagull right there. I want to put out good content that you guys are going to enjoy to watch, and something that's interesting, and something that's, you know, what you guys are subscribed to my channel for. So it's not always easy to do that whenever like, you can't do the activity that you're trying to do. So hopefully with the new bike, you know, I'll be able to make a little bit more content, do some stuff that you guys will be into watching and that'll be interesting, kind of like the old days, you know, just really grinding out riding and, you know, progressing with new tricks and working on the bike and stuff like that. It would be really cool. I'd like to do like a teardown series whenever I get ready to tear the 13 apart, and, you know, redo a lot of parts of it. That would be something that I think would be really fun to do, because it needs a lot of things to kind of bring it up to par. So I would like to do that, you know. And it's just, I don't know, man, it's kind of difficult, you know. And then of course we've had COVID and all that stuff, which for everybody that, you know, hopefully December-ish I'll be, whoa, that's a coyote. What's up, Cook? Hopefully December-ish I'll be starting to work on the teardown, because I'll have to order some parts periodically. But I'm thinking about for this, the next 13 build, I'm probably just going to go with all Cox parts, at least for the clip-ons, for the cages and sub-cages. I need to repowder my frame. My buddy 6-8 Stunts has a wiring harness for me that I need to get from him to put on the bike and just make it better. Because that one that I have, like, while it's spliced right for now, it won't be forever. So I'm gonna pull over up here and get the B-roll shots for y'all in the beginning that I promised. because I'm a little behind on making these videos in GL. So this should be a cool spot, I think. I've never been over here, so I don't know what's going on. Yikes. This little driveway road thing is a mission. It's a pretty nice day out today. It's a, oh no, pavement ends. That's not what I wanted to see. But we're gonna catch it right here before the pavement ends. How about that? Something about really getting into it. I tried to ride it real easy for the first 1,000 miles. So I really babied the crap out of it for, you know, like I said, the first 1,000 or so. And then after I got the break-in period done, I'll be riding. So like the rest of what I want to do to the bike, you know, I'm honestly pretty happy with the way the bike is. It's really comfortable, it rides really good. I'm upgrading the bars. The stock bars I don't hate, but I don't really like the way that they look. I think that like the profile of the bike looks a little better with ape hangers on it, so I'm gonna get a set of those. I have a 19 inch front wheel on here now. I want to go up to a 21, which you can do on these bikes without having to change anything, like hardware wise. You know, once you start to get 21 plus, you know, you may need to rake the front end or change your fender, brake calipers, rotors, and that sort of stuff. And I don't want to do that. So the 21 is just a big enough front wheel to kind of give it a little bit of like a leaned back look. And I don't know, I think it's more of the classic street glide look, if you will. So kind of what I'm going for. That's a cool house. And outside of that, man, I mean, I'm really happy with the way the bike is. It rides really good. Take that back. The standard does come with a regular like halogen bulb, and I want to put the LED Daymaker in there. So I'm going to do that. So it's just a couple of minor things that I'll do to it, you know, that are sort of minimal. This guy's suggesting that I go faster, I think. I don't like people riding my ass when I ride. I'm sure that's pretty universal for everybody that rides, but I can't stand it. It drives me nuts. This bike corners so good. Like for a Harley, it has a really nice lean angle. Like I feel like I could really tip this thing over and it maintains really good traction. I don't feel like it's gonna come out from under me, which is, you know, partially I'm sure because of the weight, you know, that definitely goes a long way. But it's easy to throw around too, you know, considering it being a bagger. You would think the extra weight would be, you know, a little difficult to manage, but it's really not. It's a really comfortable bike. And it's super fun to ride and super fun to handle. It's got enough get up and go for me. I don't really have an issue with it. You know, I think that it's peppy. It's not a sport bike, and that's kind of always going to be an important thing for you to remember if you get a cruiser. It's not a sport bike, and it's never going to be. So, like, there are a lot of really fast cruisers out there, and I'm not taking anything away from them. Because there are Harleys and, you know, different cruiser style bikes that will leave sport bikes. But for stock to stock acceleration versus top speed and all that stuff, I mean, you're not going to get on a CBR 1000 and then expect the same thing out of one of these. But this is a different kind of speed and it's a different kind of power. Like, this is really torquey power. It's really good, you know, out of the box, low end power that's very responsive, and it just goes. You know, it's not hard to just jet around people and, you know, catch a couple gears and really just go. All right, everybody, I'm gonna call it a day on the vlog. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you would, leave me a subscribe, comment, like, all the goodies. I'm gonna make some more videos for you guys soon, a lot more coming up. So till the next time, you guys watch some of my old videos. Later, everybody.